And hello everyone, welcome back to Terraria with the Society of Squirrels. So let's get started as soon as I refresh my dashboard. Okay, there we go. That's better. So I'm gonna unmute. Looks like Val's already on and ready to go. Hello.
Hey there, Tex. How's it going?
Good. How about you?
Not too bad. I'm a little groggy, as I mentioned in Discord, but for the people watching, the reason I'm groggy, I've been looking after a sick cat, as well as trying to work around the giving of cat medicines with my husband's work schedule, so I don't wake him up, because I have to get up and go give cat medicine, and insomnia, so I had to get 7 hours sleep last night, but I was awake for 29 before that, so I am pretty sure that 7 hours is not enough.
No, that doesn't sound like it. How's the kitty cat doing?
She's doing much better.
Okay.
She is on about day 10?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, today's her 10th day on the medicine. And, she was in some severe distress there for a few days.
I told you about having to take Teddy to the vet as well, didn't I?
You did, unless he had to go back again once more?
Yeah, that's right, because I mentioned it to you on Discord.
Yeah.
No, he's much better now. He's eating like he's starving. He's going through about 3 cans of cat food a day right now, putting weight back on.
Oh, wow. Well, I'm glad to hear that he is doing so well.
Was there anything specific wrong with your kitty?
She had a urinary infection.
Oh, okay. Yeah, those can be bad if you don't catch them early.
Yeah, she wasn't entirely stoppered up, but she was dang close. So we got her in and as an emergency to our regular vet, thankfully. We had to take her in and actually leave her there so that they could tap her bladder and check what was going on. I was worried that it might be other things, but within 24 hours, she was basically back to peeing like a racehorse in the kitty litter box, so all was well.
Well, Teddy's abandoned me for now. He's normally in my lap, but we've got the heater running right now, so he's sitting on top of the grate.
Stefan was there earlier, but she's now in her basket, which has a butt warmer in it.
Oh.
I call it the butt warmer. It's a pet bed warmer.
Uh-huh.
You plug it in.
Yep.
We've got two of them, actually. Got one for her and one for Miss Kitty. Although Miss Kitty never really cared for her. She used it once and that was it.
Oh.
Stefan absolutely adores hers, so when hers kicks the bucket, we've got a backup.
Uh-huh.
And even with the butt warmer, she sometimes complains that it's not warm enough, so I have to then cover her up with another blanket as well to, you know, keep the warmth in.
So what were we doing?
We are now getting ready for hard mode.
Okay.
So watch out on either side of our base. There's now a big straight pit that goes down. Because I've outlined our base and I'm just lining it now.
Okay.
And so basically we need to get, would you get out of here, bats? We need to do all the preparation, making of all our farms and all that sort of thing.
Where is the pit to the right of the base?
Okay, the pit to the right of the base is after the hill.
Okay.
So if you go past the hill, you'll see, I've got it covered up right now so that you can't fall in it.
I see it.
But once we go to hard mode, I'll remove that.
And a nice wide pit too.
Yes. I wanted to make sure there was no crossing the boundaries here.
So if I drop down in that, there's no rope or anything, is there?
No. There's currently nothing. You would just fall and go splat.
Let's see how much gold have I got on me.
Unless you're saved your behind with something. Oh, and speaking of saving your behind with something, Gory and I spent some time. We got everybody a bee. The bee mount.
Oh, nice.
So Gory has yours, and Greater Raiders is in the box, but since he's not going to be here
I'll take tonight, his. Yeah.
Yeah, just take his from the box, and I'll try to remember to remind Gory to put the one he has in that box.
And my vacation is over today, or yesterday. I have to go back to work on Monday.
My commiserations. And Nico, your cat's meowing at the monitor. Your cat either likes or dislikes Terraria. I'm not sure which. And Tweeter on YouTube, hello, welcome to the stream. Dang bats. So I don't think there's any point in changing the background wall too, is there?
No.
Yeah. I mean, for aesthetic purposes maybe, but I don't think we have so many. We don't have an excess of materials, so I'd rather not do that if I don't have to. It's well lit. I got torches everywhere.
Oh boy, it's so much easier getting around on a bee mount.
Oh, it is. Yes. Those are so hard to get, you know?
Uh-huh.
I didn't realize how hard they were to get because in my solo first time I played through Terraria on stream, I got one. I don't think I had too much trouble getting it, so at least I don't remember having a lot of trouble getting it. So I didn't realize they were so hard to get.
Oh, there you are.
Yes. So what do you think of my pit?
I like it. The only thing I would do different is...
Oops.
And this is just me being paranoid. I would make the bottom taller.
The bottom taller?
Well, no, that's actually as tall as I would do it.
Yeah, because I was told that it had to be at least 5 wide with the gap of 3 in between and then the lining on either side counting as the 4th and 5th.
Uh-huh.
And I actually made it wider than that, so I made it. This one is this big because I used dynamite.
Nice, and when we go to hard mode, we've got a bee's spider's nest right there.
Yes. Yes, I made sure I didn't cut through the middle of it. I just went underneath it. That's why when I was figuring out where to put it, I actually kind of figured out where the spider nest was so that it was easy for us to access.
Uh-huh.
And we didn't destroy it. So.
Boy, I hate those bats.
Oh, I know. I think I'd find them less annoying if they didn't do knockback, despite the fact of them inflicting no damage. And they didn't make me go, ow, 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 ow. It's like, if they're not hurting me, why am I going, ow, 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 ow?
Exactly.
So, if they just change that. So if something does no damage to you, they do no knockback, especially if they're much smaller than you. They do no knockback and you don't go, ow. Then I wouldn't care about bats. But they knock you off ropes. They're just a real pain in the behind.
Mm-hmm. So do we have any extra stones so that I can help?
Yes, there should be more stone in the box, the block box. And the reason I chose the slab, and Gory did a quick test, and it looks like we won't have a problem with things crossing the plane block, because they only use one stone each, so.
Oh. Uh-huh.
So they're much cheaper.
And thank you for the host. Very much appreciated.
Well, I'm glad your cat's enjoying the Terraria there, Nico. Yeah, that'll do.
Ooh, and we get hard, when we get hard mode, we'll have the rainbow slimes.
Yes. That'll be fun. I like those.
I do too. Hey, Jax. How are you? Welcome.
I'm trying to get... Should I go to the bottom? Yeah, let's just go to the bottom.
There were extra blocks in a chest.
I thought there was. Hang on, let me check my inventory here. Yeah, I do not... I only had one stack, so there should be more raw block, or like raw stone, that you can turn into the stuff. I should go from the top down. If there isn't, then I'm going to have to go look, because there should have been at least one to two more stacks of stone that I hadn't turned into blocks yet. As it is, we still might need to do some excavating to get more stone. The other side, I haven't cleaned up. The vertical shaft, I haven't cleaned up yet, so if you wanted to do the cross shaft...
That's what I was going to do.
Okay, sounds good.
So, you're doing which stone?
I'm doing the stone slab, because it requires one, one block to make. So our stone goes much further.
And Jax, I have noticed a difference. So, I thank you for the advice. There was no offense taken. Jax suggested me changing the angle of my camera.
Oh.
So that it looks like I'm actually talking to chat.
Yeah. I think this pack rat actually flips his screen, so it look when he looks towards the screen, it looks like he's... And looks at chat, it looks like he's looking towards, you know, you.
And that's kind of what I was... What I did. So
okay.
When I'm looking at the game, it now looks like I'm looking at chat, because that's usually how I'm talking to chat, is while I'm playing the game. So mm-hmm. Now it looks like I'm talking to chat.
Cool. And your cat is enjoying the mouse cursor on the screen. Well, here, let me torture the cat a little bit by moving the mouse cursor around. and there's Gore. Woohoo! Unfortunately, Greater Raider won't be with us today. I think I messed that up. Because he is just finishing up his extra work from holidays. Next weekend, he should be back to normal.
It looks a lot more natural now, Jax, which I like.
Ah, thank you, Gore.
I can't... Where do I create the stone slabs? The furnace?
I honestly can't remember. It's either the furnace or the work table, I think.
Now, I see gray brick. Am I using the wrong stone? It's with stone block, isn't it?
It's just, just you take the raw stone, not the bricks, but the raw stone, and you just make it directly. One raw stone equals one stone slab.
I don't even have an option for a stone slab.
Well,
maybe it has to be brick before I can make...
No, don't turn them into bricks. I'll be right there. I'm just finishing up the last of my stack. I have to come back for a stack anyway.
I found it.
You found it? Okay. Am I making two stacks while you're at it? Yeah, one stack basically lined one vertical shaft. Exactly. Which is kind of amazing, actually.
And, Jax, I'm open to any advice like that. Especially when it comes to setting up the camera.
Oh, I guess I could... let's see. Is that what I meant to do? No, that's not what I meant to do. There we go. No imps. There we go.
I've been playing too many other video games. I'm getting my keys all mixed up. I keep hitting tab in order to open inventory, or E to open inventory.
Yes, me too. Yes, I've been,
Hey, call me sect.
While I was not in streaming shape, I've been checking out Stardew Valley.
Uh-huh.
I did not realize that it basically is a PC version of a game that I used to play on the DS called Harvest Moon.
And thank you for the follow.
I mean, he wrote it from scratch. It's, yep. You know, uses all its own art and stuff, so it's not like a ripoff or anything. Yes, I've been playing a lot of that. I want to play it through once, so I understand how all the parts work before I actually stream it. I've already added a few mods, but anyway, go ahead.
There's a stack and 500.
Where? In the box? On the floor?
Yeah. It should be on the very bottom. The blocks box.
The blocks
very
box.
Bottom right corner.
Yeah, I see it. Yep. Awesome. I snag both of those. And I'll go work on the other shaft. I meant to measure that one when I was there.
So I'm going to go start working on the horizontal shaft. No.
Okay.
So, vertical shaft. No, horizontal shaft. One of those.
Ah. It's a Terraria Moon. No. No, it is very, very similar to Harvest Moon. It has things that... It's like Harvest Moon with additional features.
Well, I've been hearing a lot of people comparing it to Harvest Moon.
It is, like, I loved Harvest Moon. I played, I think, the first two or three in the series, and then I started to lose interest in it, and now I understand why. I will explain that if people are curious what I mean by that, but, where did that go? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, and Jax, no, advice like that is absolutely no problem whatsoever. I'm not really working on growth, but I am interested in improving my channel. So, it's improving first and growth second. Let's see if I can do this right before I hit the bottom.
Let's stand here and measure. So I have to measure the width in inside it. So that, I need to measure that. Which means I need to turn on the ruler. It is 12 wide. So that means the shaft itself needs to be 14 and then lined. 12. Remember that. 12. It's been a few years since I played. I feel like I'm on a very bumpy road right now.
It looks funny.
It's been a few years since I played Harvest Moon on the DS, but everything that I do remember about it is present in Stardew Valley.
Dang slime.
It does have a few things that I have changed using mods for various reasons. The first is the default time passage.
Uh-huh.
Is I think 10 minutes passes every 7 seconds. So time to me passes super fast in the game, and it really gives you that feeling of gotta hurry, can't waste a second, rush, which doesn't make it really relaxing.
Uh-huh.
So I have used a mod to basically double that, which is about the right pace for me. I've also added a mod that lets you see how much things are worth when they're in your inventory. So when you hover over something, it says, this will sell for 50 gold.
Oh, okay.
Which is very handy.
That is handy.
And the other thing that I've changed, I tried the vanilla fishing mechanics.
Oh.
It
is
unfortunately
horrible.
Is dex-based. And it's Twitch dex-based. Neither of those things I am good at. So I tried it. I tried fishing about 100 times. Now, granted, I was a zero level fisher, so, you know, I sucked. My character sucked at fishing, but I was fishing in the area where the easiest fish were supposed to be available, which is basically the river. I caught one fish.
Wow.
One. And so I went looking for a mod to make the fishing easier. After reading on the forums that there were a lot of other people in the same boat, people who had dexterity issues, people who had arthritis, people who could not click fast enough. And there was no way in-game to change, you know, how hard it was.
Uh-huh.
And that's the only complaint, I guess I could say, out of the hours that I think I've spent about 30 hours playing it so far. That's my only real big complaint about it. Is that the fishing is severely dex-based, and if you're not really a dexterous person, fishing is going to frustrate you like nothing else. And since I play games to enjoy them, not to frustrate myself, after trying 100 times and only getting one fish and no skill increase, I said, forget this. I need to make it easier for myself. So I did that. But if I do decide to stream it, I will definitely let people know what I've done and why. Because some people will be like, oh, you're cheating.
You know,
it's like,
if I had known,
if I was dexterous enough, I would be playing the base game. I tried it and I just couldn't do it.
Well, and if I'd known you hadn't tried Terraria or Stardew until now, I would have suggested it to you.
Oh, I've had a few people suggest it to me, and I had kept an eye on it. The thing was, is that oddly enough, I watched a few videos on YouTube about it.
Uh-huh.
And for some reason, the way that those videos were presented did not tell me this is like Harvest Moon. If I had known that, I would have been on it like a dirty shirt. Because I love Harvest Moon, the old Harvest Moon. So if I had known Stardew was like Harvest Moon, I would have been there day one.
Ah, okay.
But I did not, so I was not.
What All is right. that?
So now we need 12. And when I was standing here, so
yeah,
12.
I even liked Star... Oh, that's a piece of track.
I think it's right here.
And a strange piece of block.
Yep. Oh, and Private Dijon, I'm sorry I missed that. Hello, welcome to the stream. Only 5 minutes late.
Yeah, Private Dijon's a nice guy.
Yes. Yes, he is.
Oh, I'm out of blocks.
And Nico, no, I didn't, unfortunately. Is that archived anywhere? Other than being a little tired, Private Dijon, I'm not doing too bad. How about you? It's dark. It's so dark. Okay.
No. It's gonna take more than a stack for the bottom floor. For the horizontal. I'd guess about 2.5 stacks.
Okay, so that means we got some manning in our future.
Yep.
With dynamite, it's much faster. I'm glad to hear you're not doing too bad. Oh, you did it a long time ago, Nico.
Food chest.
Do I know where the pumpkins are? You mean the grown...
There should be a bunch in the food chest. Because I went through and picked a bunch. While it was Halloween.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't light this up at all. Because I was trying to get this down shaft done before the end of the... stream last time, and that didn't include any fanciness like lighting, so we gotta clean it up, which means let's head to the top here. Okay, let's put a... Do I have... Yes, I do have. I don't need the mining potion on right now, so let's just do that. Hey, there's a heart right here.
Oh.
Well, it'll be for either you or Greater Raider, because I'm now at 400, and I believe so is Gore.
Yeah, I'm only at 340.
Yeah, okay. I believe there's some extra in the chests. And I have one on me now for you. Was that gold I saw up there? I thought I saw gold up here. Am I hallucinating? I could be hallucinating. Yes, it is nice to be able to mod it, Nico. That's for sure. I always try a game to play it through base as if possible, and it's particularly for a stream. I only mod things that either absolutely drive me nuts and ruin the game for me, or that I physically cannot do. Like the aforementioned fishing. I tried hard. I tried to, because the harvest moon fishing, I had no problem with that. I was able to do that fishing. So I can't remember exactly how that fishing went, just that I had no problem with it and actually really liked it. So oh, achieving greatness. Do you know it's 2017? I probably have the wrong... Yeah, I just realized when you said that I have the wrong year on my stream title. Sorry about that. I will fix it later. I'll fix it, and this evening's stream will have the correct date on it. It's because I copy old events, and I changed the first part of the date, but not the last. Oops.
Stupid bats.
Either that or... Yes. Either that or I'm living in the past. There's always that.
That almost sounds like a Jethro Tull song.
Yeah, Nico, the fishing in Stardew is very hard. And some people enjoy how hard it is, and that's great for them. If I were faster at clicking, because you have to click pretty fast. If I was faster at clicking and also not worried about carpal tunnel, I would not have an issue with it. Okay, so we need it at 1602. Okay, so that is where I believe I'm coming up. So if that is the case, then this... Come on, you. Okay. That should be the up. Right there. Like that. Yeah. Okay, we'll see how correct I am. It's first dig down. Oh, I guess we could measure this too while we're up here. Let's turn this on. Whoop, whoop. Come on. There. So 12 is right there, which means this should go like so. Okay. So we'll see. I'm just going to do the digging now and double check my measurements.
Yeah, we'll have to come back and relight this tunnel.
Ah. Not about speed or rhythm and pattern. Well, that is true, Nico, but it's also
a pain in the butt.
A pain in the butt. Because even if you, as I've explained before with certain things, even if I know what I need to do, if I can't physically do it, it doesn't help knowing it. And now that I've used the mod to slow it down so that I can actually do the clicking, I do see that there is a rhythm and pattern to it. But with, okay, this, I'm almost embarrassed to admit this, but with the easiest version, the super easy version of the fishing, I mean, what they consider super easy version, that's the first, I tried the medium one first, still couldn't do it. Super easy version, I can actually see that there's a pattern and rhythm to it now. I could not before. Like, I couldn't get any kind of grasp on it because I can't click fast enough. So I'm not sure what you mean, Nico. Who did I go for? Yeah, you'll have to explain that. As far as I recall, I didn't kill anybody.
Have I said how much I don't like the bats?
Probably about the same time as I was complaining about the bats. Uh-huh. Yes. Who do I like? Oh, are you talking about the romantic stuff or the just all the characters? Like I said, I'm still not quite sure what it is you're asking. For the romantic stuff, it just depends. Because, you know, you get the... Basically, it's a way of recruiting somebody to help you do a few things. And usually, it just kind of depends on... I do a light... Even playing by myself, I do kind of a light role play, so it just depends on my character. For my learning run through, my character has chosen Elliot, the writer by the beach.
My problem with that is they've set it up so that you almost have to have some type of relationship in there.
Yeah.
And I don't want that. I want to do my farm. I want to do my own thing. I don't want a relationship.
I know with Harvest Moon, the first few times I played it, I basically ignored that until I'd been in-game, I'd been in for a few years. Is Stardew different that you have to do it? I mean, I didn't really... I just did it as a matter of course because I was used to it in Harvest Moon, but...
I don't know if you have to. It just felt like you had to.
Ah. I don't think you have to. Basically, the stuff that they do, while it's nice, it's not, like, super useful. Like, for example, they'll feed the animals.
Mm-hmm.
Well, once you get the bigger barn, it auto-feeds them anyway in the trough.
True.
Fixes fences. That saves you a little bit of time. You know, so it's not huge. So, if Nico's played through it, maybe Nico can comment on whether you have to choose a relationship or not. Oh, you like Elliot, eh? Fine choice. One of the things that I do like about both about the Harvest Moon and Stardew Valley is the fact that you can choose, you don't have to choose the opposite gender. You can choose the same gender.
Oh, that's a gore.
Hmm?
Oh, no, that's you.
Huh? What?
You're up right next to me.
No, I'm not. That has to be Gore. I'm 1,300 blocks away.
Oh, no, that is Gore. Okay.
Yeah. But I think that was the first game that I remember seeing that in, and I thought, that is awesome.
Shoot.
I am glad that they have that. Ah, that's who you chose, eh, Nico? Cool.
I need to drain some water. Oh, it drained.
I think I left gaps in the floor so that water could run out.
Well, it also broke all the torches I put down.
Oh, I see.
Hey, Demoness.
Torch. Oh, what? Whoop, whoop, whoop. Come on, put that. Okay, what is going on here? Okay, my mouse seems to be having an issue. There we go. The heck? Do not push random buttons on the mouse. It gets upset.
Yes, it does. Oh, that's where it went down. Okay, that works.
A torch launcher. That would be lovely. You can just kind of shoot the torches up where they need to go. As it is, we have to make do with things that emit light, like so. Made me very sad to find out this no longer gave light, unless I'm doing it wrong, unless there's some setting that I don't have checked. If there is, I'd like to know what it is, because that would be so handy.
What? What does it give
the light? The grand design. It's a new thing. Well, new to me anyway. Where you put together all the wrenches and some various bits and bobs, and you end up with a tool that you can use to measure things and highlight wires and cut them. And what you used to be able to do was, and I saw Packrat doing it in his stream, is you could actually run it over the dark areas of the map when you're caving.
Uh-huh.
Like drawing a line, and it would light the area up. Like it would emit light so that you could see what you were doing.
Uh-huh.
And then the light would go away, but it would leave the cave lit up on your mini-map. But it doesn't seem to do that light anymore. So either they changed it so it doesn't do it anymore because people were actually using that feature and they didn't like that, or I've got some of the settings incorrect on it, so...
Or like in Minecraft, they complained about it being too OP and took it out.
Yeah, I really... In incoming small vent... it really bothers me when people call something OP when it's something that you've spent time to acquire.
Yep.
Because to me, the time that you've invested in order to get whatever it is, even if once you've got it, you don't need to continue to invest time, does not mean that item is OP. What you need to do is balance how much effort needs to go in to get that thing and not just nerf the thing.
Well, not only that, but it may already be balanced enough. It's the problem that I've seen is people are calling stuff OP only because they're using it so often that they've gotten used to it and they've gotten bored with it. It's not that it's OP, it's just that they're bored with that mod.
Yeah, that could be. Or they figured out how to use it to its maximum effectiveness and get there in as short a period as possible.
What happened there?
So, yeah, but that always bothers me when people say OP. I'm always like, is it really OP or is it just a case of you don't like the fact that you've used it, got so used to it, and don't need it anymore? Like you said.
And 90% of the time when I've heard people talk about something being OP, it's that they're tired of using that mod and it's really easy for them. It's not that it's OP.
Yeah. I thought I would have some stuff here. I guess not. It was meant for lighting up wiring, not lighting up caves. Yeah. Now, see, if that's the original intent of it, and that's why they changed it, I don't have a problem with that. Because realistically, the grand plan as it is currently is fairly easy to get. It's basically having the money and getting the mechanic. It's not... Oh, and the goblin, right? And the goblin, because you got to put the pieces together. So that's why I'm not super upset that ability was removed. I was just curious as to whether it actually was or if I had was just not using it correctly.
Thank you,
but
Demoness.
There's other things, other, like, not in Terraria, but other games and stuff where people are like, oh, this is OP, and it's like, no, I just spent 60 hours in game grinding to get this thing. I've invested time to get it, so...
Exactly.
They're being too whiny. Yeah, Nico, and I think sometimes people just complain because they need something to complain about.
Yep.
It's the internet, you know?
Well, my problem with people using OP at all is the devs listen.
Yes.
They're paying attention to what people are saying, and sometimes they'll completely screw up their mod because they're listening to these people say that it's OP when it's really not. I mean, you invest mm-hmm. a lot of time and resources into something, then a couple of people complain that it's OP because they're tired of playing with it.
And then ruin it for everybody
else.
And
ruin it for everyone else. I mean, I was here listening to someone complain about how the AE2 was OP. It's not OP. I mean, you have to put a lot of time and resources into it. What he was complaining about was he's used it so much that it's just routine to go through and create it, and he's tired of it. Not because mm-hmm. it's OP.
I now have 3 bombs. That's lovely. I would prefer to have this. Thank you. Let's just put that there. Nico, that could be too. Nico is saying that in their deeper mind, like, you mean subconscious, they don't want people who the people who have already got it and used it don't want other people to use it to get as good as they are.
I could see that happening too. No, but like I said, most of the time when I hear people complaining about something being OP, it's not OP, it's that they're tired of that mod.
Mm-hmm.
They've used it so many times and gone through the initial setup so much that it's just rote for them, and they think that because it's rote for them, it's rote for everyone. And they're bored with it.
And Gory saying doesn't like how people say mass storage blocks in Minecraft are OP. In vanilla, it's just wood. Yeah, I mean... Yeah. People use the word OP way too much for things that it doesn't belong on.
Yep.
It's like my complaints about people using the word cheating.
Yep.
When it's something that either has been is intended by the developer... So, like, take a look at Minecraft. Creative mode. Guess what? It's not cheating. It's intended.
Yeah.
Because if it wasn't, you wouldn't be able to use creative, right?
Yep.
I don't use creative when I'm building things, but if I happen to have to go into creative to do something, that doesn't make it cheating.
No.
And as well, like, talking about things that give... people with disabilities access to games. You know, like me just talking about the fact that I'm not very dexterous and I had to use the what some people might consider a cheat in order to be able to enjoy the game.
Uh-huh.
Because there's something that I tried, but I just could not do. And just because someone plays a game differently than you do does not make what they're doing cheating. If it's their own game, the only game they could theoretically ruin is their own. Now, when you're talking about multiplayer games, then that's a different discussion. Because if what you're doing affects other people, then yes, that needs to be addressed.
Now, Jax, am I going to have to add a mod me command?
Anyway, enough Val rants for now.
I'm giving Jax a hard time about a typo he just made.
Ah. excuse me. A short word is jealous. Yes, I could be. And that's my motto too, Nico. As long as you're not ruining somebody else's game, play it the way you like. And that's always my caveat. As long as it doesn't affect somebody else's game. And just a moment while I pause to clear my throat.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I think we're good.
I'm digging up more stone.
Okay. You could always blow it up. That's always fun.
Does that destroy blocks?
No, it does not. I did research on that.
Oh.
No, in Terraria, it does not destroy blocks. It just breaks them.
Huh.
Hopefully my source is not wrong. At least from what I've seen, my source is not wrong. So I use it for mining meteorites now too. Because it's faster, you're less likely to get whacked by the meteor heads, and you end up with the same stuff. Nico. Yeah, I bet your cat was just thrilled about having a set of headphones on their head. No, get it off! Oh my god, I'm dying! You know, like how cats act when you do something like, say, put a collar on them for the first time?
Try a harness sometime.
Actually, I have put harnesses on cats. And, yes, most of them just kind of fall over like you just attached a weight to them.
That's the way my cats were.
The only cat that I've ever had so far in my life that did not do that is Val the cat.
Oh.
Now, we got him as a stray. He was about 9 months old when we rescued him. So it is possible he had a harness on him before he was abandoned. But I put it on him and he was like, woohoo, this is great. So I'm like, okay. Got to get rid of that or somebody's going to jump down here and kill themselves on it, like me, for example.
Yeah, the Bengal that we had would have been like that if we had ever put him in a harness.
Ah.
Unfortunately, he passed away from lymphoma a couple of years ago.
Oh, yeah, I'll just say, because I didn't remember you talking about the Bengal.
And a worm now.
Okay, so we need to be on 1577. Gonna have to check out some of these caves after that I didn't light up all the way, that I just ignored in favor of doing work. No, 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 R, thank you. Oh, crap. Oh, I just lost it. Fine. It's time for Octoval.
Did I miss that or break it? I may have broken it. I broke it.
I don't know what your cat did, Nico. I'm neither psychic nor am I spying on you.
T. Costa, yeah, after 9 p.m. Pacific time, I'll be playing more 7 Days to Die.
What? There we go. Okay.
Yeah, Saturdays is the Society of Squirrels, so that's going to be every Saturday.
Yes. I picked B, Nico.
I keep hitting tab to open my inventory.
Mm-hmm. I keep hitting E to open my inventory because, well, I've been playing Stardew, so. The Demonist, hello! Welcome to the stream! How are you doing today?
I didn't clean out my Sorin chest.
No, it's still there. I didn't touch it.
It's unusual. Well, no, I usually clean it out at the end of the day.
Well, I know you intend to, but the last two or three times it's not been. That's why I chuckled when you said you usually did. You made a building over by the Western Crimson. Oh, yeah! I'm just looking at it on the mini-map, but it looks pretty cool. I'll have to go have a look at it, Gore. Once I finish digging this line down, I'll pop over and take a look at it in person as opposed to on the mini-map. Get out of here! You are not going to do that. It looks kind of eastern, at least in outline. The answer was C. Your cat walked away with your headphones. I see.
You know, and Jax, I've been really lucky. I haven't had too many problems with my chat so far.
All right.
Why? How come I couldn't fly? I don't understand.
I don't know. I'm just practicing my technique of using the both of them. The vines and the bee. And I'm so far not doing a great job. Nope, hit R first. There we go.
Well, the mount couldn't even make it over the lava at our farm.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It got tired.
Immediately? As soon as I mounted it?
Oh. That? I don't know.
Now it's flying fine.
I'll have to pay attention to that. Maybe there's a glitch where sometimes... If you put him away wet and tired, he comes out wet and tired.
It took me a little while to get into this as well, Demoness. The problem I had originally was I had trouble getting started with it. Hey, Rollo. I didn't understand what I needed to do first day. That's actually how I got to know Val.
Yes. Ooh, it's made out of honey.
Oh.
And the chests are made out of honey, too. Honey and pumpkins. Is it wrong that I want to lick the chest? I bet it tastes good. And the honey bed. Wow, looks cool, Gore. It's a sweet building.
Yeah,
sweet, you can shoot me now.
Sweet build, man.
Yeah. It is a honey temple. A temple, is it a temple to honey as well? I'm not sure. There's a jack-o'-lantern up there. Maybe it's a temple to jack-o'-lanterns. It's the Crimson Spawn Hut. Well, it's a fabulous spawn hut. It's, I have to admit, my huts are never this elaborate. Cool, Gore. I look forward to see what your next spawn hut's going to look like. What's your next project? Just out of curiosity. Not trying to put you on the spot or anything. If you haven't decided yet, just say so. Just curious. You're going to annihilate some bosses. Alrighty. So, incoming boss spam. Gotcha. If you're going to spawn a bunch of them at the same time, maybe you'd be a little further away than last time. Was it the end of...
Did he kill you again?
No, actually, well, I could have died. What happened was, not last stream, but the stream before that, so 2 weeks ago, Gore, just as I was ending the stream, spawned about 10 queen bees or something,
because
we were trying to get the ride, the flying mount for you guys. And Gore spawned them. He died, and they all decided to come and hunt me out. Now, unfortunately, I had already put my end screen up, so all everybody heard was me frantically fighting for my life. But they couldn't see anything. So I lived. I killed like 8 of them and survived. I don't know how, but I did. But I was like totally silent because I listened to it after, and all you could hear was this, and all the noises the queen bees were making.
Uh-huh.
And I was like, dang, if only that had happened before I put my end screen up, that would have been hilarious for people to watch. But unfortunately, all they could hear is the fight, not see it. So that's why I was saying to Gory, I hope the next batch doesn't go like that.
Well, I'm sure Gory wouldn't do something like that on purpose.
Oh no, it wasn't on purpose. Gory just spawned them a little too close, and when Gory, I'm not sure how Gory died and I survived, but in any case, it was quite amusing. Because I was so busy fighting, I couldn't even end my stream until I finished fighting. Oh, that armor doesn't work as well as armor. Yeah, that makes sense. And no one will ever know. No, well, you can hear the fight, and then I realized my stream was still up, so I ended it. But so I didn't actually say anything. Yeah, that would have made an awesome thing. Me just, you know, casually finishing up my stream and suddenly being attacked by a forest of queen bees. But alas.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I guess maybe if I do this. There we go. Oops. Now I can cling to it. Whoops. There we go. I'm going to remove the background. This one does go through another spider nest.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to remove the background in the tunnel itself going down. So we actually have two spider's nests we can mess with. Isn't the put the block from downstairs easier? Yeah, but, you know. I have to press the key about the same amount of times, so. It's all measured out and nice and neat, so I'm not too worried about that aspect of it. Oops, not down far enough. There we go.
Our tunnel down with the rope ladder is currently blocked off. Just so you know, so you don't drop down and die when you hit it.
Oh, I see. So I understand. So we have to line that too. And I think I'll dig down the two, take the walls out so that we can do that.
Okay.
Once I finish up here, that is. Just wondering if I wanted to do the background here while I'm hanging about. Now we'll come back up and tidy it up.
Angry depth meter.
Somebody take that depth meter off.
I know.
Probably called it OP. That ticked me off too.
Yes, Demoness, I got him as soon as he came in.
You had an asshat visit, did you?
Oh, I was just one of these guys posting such and such donated such and such amount. I just immediately ban them.
Oh, they're trying to fake it?
Uh-huh. Because I don't take donations.
OP triggered.
I don't worry about it, Demoness. He's one of the mods in my channel.
Mm-hmm. There you go. I have to say I'm having much less issue with bats now that I've remembered to. A little while ago, I brought my woke my imp up. Since then, you may have noticed I haven't been complaining about the bats. So you may want to do that too.
I completely forgot about that.
There we go. So now let's go up and do that cleanup work. On the wall. Hey, you made it. Awesome. Okay, so yes, that's on, so we are good. And let's get the tin hammer out. Oops. Smart Val.
Can't wait until I get my spider staff.
That is true, Demoness.
What?
Stupid people are stupid.
Yeah.
Yes, I like the spider staff too.
Okay. Tunnel is lined. Let me make sure I didn't miss anything.
There we go.
No, can I be, looks good.
I would like to be centered. Okay, I guess I can't be centered.
Maybe meditation?
I might want to invest in a better hammer. This one's a little slow. Especially if I'm going to work on a lot of backgrounds, like if the elevator, for example, that one needs to be lined.
Mm-hmm.
So I might want to consider.
Well, and the elevator, you don't need to do all of it either. The only part that needs to be lined is from the horizontal tunnel down.
Why is that?
Because anything above that's going to be protected by the tunnel itself.
Oh, you're not going to leave it open?
No, it's got the... Actually, if you'll come down here, I'll show you what I mean. You might want to line it just for looks, but you don't have to line the elevator. The only part that you need to line is the bottom part.
Hey, you have a section of the roof here that's offset up.
Yeah, I know.
You gonna fix it?
I hadn't planned on it.
I'll fix it then. It bugs me.
That's why I left it.
To bug me.
Oh. Well, not to bug you particularly, but see, from here up, this horizontal shaft is going to keep any corruption or crimson from getting above.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Actually, yeah, that's true.
So we don't have to line anything above that.
That's true.
It would be nice to go ahead and do it, but we don't have to.
Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, I would like to line it just for looks. But you're right, we don't have to.
Yeah. No, I was mainly doing that for chat, leaving that.
Oh, I see. You're triggering them.
Yep.
Ah, gotcha. You were trolling chat.
Yeah. Not that I would do something like that, but...
No, that was totally by accident. Entirely. I fortunately do not have OCD, but because I do understand how horrible it can truly be, I have tendencies to OCD, which I fight, because, like, in real life, like, things like needing to check the alarm clock 5 times to make sure it's actually set to the right time, even though I just checked it 3 times in a row, I have to check it again, so, yeah. But as far as buildings go, I will actually build things that are asymmetrical and stuff, and it doesn't bother me, so I know I don't have it. Ah, Asperger's often comes with obsessive compulsions. Are you telling us something about yourself there, Gore?
Well, I've got some obsessive compulsive. That's part of the reason why I get into games so deeply and for such a long time. So I've learned to focus that obsessive compulsive into the areas that I want.
Ah. See, that way you kind of turn a negative into a bit of a positive, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
And that's, I think, a good idea.
Took a long time to learn to do that, but yeah.
Yeah, it takes a long time to do that sort of thing. You can only use a certain kind of fork. Oh, okay. You have these curvy forks and these straight forks, and you just can't use the straight ones. It bugs you.
I can understand
that. That's interesting. Trying to think if there's anything else that I have that is sort of has to be just so.
Yeah, and for me, when I get into something, I get into something.
Mm-hmm.
So when I show an interest in something, then I really show an interest in something.
Yeah.
It's like
I can relate to that.
When I was doing crochet.
And you crochet?
Yeah.
Cool.
And thank you for the host, Lapis, Lori. I appreciate that.
And I'll do that too. I'll have, that's why when I stream, I typically don't change my game. Because once I'm in a certain game, I'm in that game for the day. And if I have to change, then it really throws me off.
Lapis Lori raid.
Oh,
welcome,
cool.
Everyone. Salsa Doom, Zapdos. Welcome, everyone.
So right now, the only exception I have for that is my patron games, where I will always play. Even if I'm not playing Minecraft, I'll be playing the patron games that day.
Shout out. And thank you for the follow.
Nico gave an interesting what's the word? Definition for OCD. Oh, that ceiling is driving me crazy.
Am I a little gray today? Oh, that gray. No, it's not gray, it's blonde. It's blonde. Yeah, let me give them my spiel real quick on channel setup. I'm going to mute for just a second while I talk to them.
Alrighty. Now I want to cough.
Okay. For the people just arriving, I am a PG streamer, so I do keep it clean. Even though I've got my channel set for a mature audience, I am PG, and I expect chat to be PG. The reason why I've got it set as mature is I usually have people who are in voice with me that are not mature. So that's why I have that warning up. I'm normally an evening streamer, so I keep it pretty calm and cool. A very chill stream. So I just wanted to give you all a heads up about that. So back to the game.
So I will steal them back.
I was just giving them the warning about being PG.
Oh, yes.
And thank you for the follows.
I just reclaimed those extra bricks from the ceiling. Since we're kind of short on blocks. So if you're leaving it there to mess with people, I'm sorry.
Oh, even the toothpick was getting to you?
No, it didn't. It wasn't that it was bugging me. I just figured we'd need the blocks.
Oh, yeah. No, I've still got 76 blocks left. Oh, okay, but we've still got to do the elevator.
Yeah, we still have the elevator to do.
Okay, yeah, we need the blocks. What's a good place to go mining for stone?
Well, if you look at the map where we've done our tunnel, there's stone above and below. Like, large amounts of it. At least that you can see in the non-gray areas. And Nico, the answer to that question is, we are both old enough to know not to answer that question.
Oh, and the number one rule in my channel is no age talk, no politics talk, and no religion talk.
Yes.
So, just no.
Yeah.
If you have to ask a question like that, you need to go back and read the rules again.
It's always good to go back and reread the rules periodically anyway.
Yeah.
Just in case, you know, they've been updated or whatever. And for people watching on YouTube, I do have the rules at the top of the description of every stream. So, quick and easy for you to refresh your memory.
Thank you, Demoness. And let me do something real quick. Run Wild has not said hi in chat, so Salsa Doom and Christopher Whitley and Zapdos, thank you for the follows. Very much appreciated.
Oh my, at all the crap I've got in my inventory. I guess we should go.
Well, Runwald, I normally don't call out lurkers. That's one of the reasons why I don't have names popping up for hosts or for follows. And I didn't realize until after I said it, I didn't mean to call you out. So sorry about that. But if you say hi in chat, then I'll thank people by name for the follows or hosts. Sorry about that.
Yeah, and I follow that rule as well. Although I don't normally announce it quite so nicely. do that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I go ahead and announce it every once in a while because every now and then I get people who go ahead and say hi afterwards. We've got the skeleton merchant up here. Do we need anything?
I don't think so. That's okay, Nico. It's a question I often get. All right.
Okay, yeah, so and thank you.
In the precious chest, there's currently 7 life crystals. So if you want it to top off to 400. Tax.
What was that? Oh. Yeah, I should. I was looking at what the skeleton merchant had.
Ah. Because you need 3 to get to 400, right?
Yeah.
So hopefully there's enough in there that Greater Reader will also be able to get to 400 as well. Really? We don't have any in the banner chest. Oh, it's an ice bat one. That's probably why.
Oh, which chest is it in? Precious.
Yes, precious.
Okay.
Wait a minute. I think I just did something. I just did a thing. I didn't mean to. I want my mining potions back. Took them out for a reason. Because I'm digging. I suppose I should actually get some blocks too. Because I'm probably going to have to do some block. That's not the right
choice. Yeah, 3 gets me to 400. I think that's max, isn't it?
It's max until we can start eating the life fruits, yeah.
Okay. Hey, Tossie. How are you? It's a good game, Runwild. Not as much fun as 7 Days to Die, but that's only because I'm obsessed with that game right now.
Yeah, he's obsessed with that one, and I'm obsessed with Stardew Valley. Yeah. Although I haven't been streaming yet, because I wanted to play it through first. Because I wanted to come at it from... Because I'm so familiar with... Harvest Moon, I wanted to come at it from a more experienced kind of viewpoint. Which is why I wanted to play it through first once.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. A fun game, especially with a lot of the updates. I've been really happy with some of the updates that they've had with Terraria. You haven't messed with the new mechanic yet, have you, Val? The tower defense, or
no, I haven't. I've seen it. I haven't done anything with it yet. No.
Okay. That will be interesting multiplayer.
Yeah, that could be interesting multiplayer. I'm sure they probably tweaked it for multiplayer to make it harder.
I'm sure they have. Where was that?
All right, what am I doing? I am after blocks. Fill blocks is what I want. And so let's take some dirt. That works for me. All right. You're looking forward to the Stardew Valley live stream already. Okay, good. Might be a bit before it happens, but I'm pretty sure it'll happen at some point. There we go. All right, now we can buff up. Indeed. For a spot like this, I will use... No, no, that's not... Don't do that, Val. Bad. Wrong.
Oh, okay. Well, that explains the difficulty of expert mode.
Expert mode is balanced around multiplayer. Ah! Yes, that does explain it.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're playing expert mode single player, that's why it's so really hard.
Uh-huh. Is it just me or is it a little laggy today?
Well, I did ask Greater Raider to restart it around noon, I think I asked him. So it does seem to need restarting periodically.
Well, lag isn't bad, but there's a little bit there.
Okay. Well, that's interesting, Gory. I did not know that. That the reward bags from bosses drop client-side so every player gets one.
Mm-hmm.
That... Cool. That is an excellent thing that they did.
Tossy, have you completely played through Diablo? That's one I was thinking about going back to. I liked Diablo.
Thinking of making some gem blocks for lighting. In the walls, in the elevator.
Well, that's a good idea.
Unless anybody has any plans for gems, that's what I'd like to do.
I certainly don't have any plans for them. I usually just keep them for selling.
Leave them.
No, single player, I don't even bother with the, grappling hooks.
Oh, really?
That's why I'm so terrible with them.
Ah. I love grappling hooks.
To open my inventory.
Oops. I accidentally let some water down. I was too busy digging and not paying attention. Sorry.
Am I gonna have to replace all those torches again?
That's why I put them on the ceiling.
Yeah, but behind the slabs, they don't light up the tunnel anymore.
Oh, behind slabs they don't?
Yeah.
Well, once I finish digging this out, then it won't happen again. I'll fix the lights. Yeah,
I know how to fix it.
Well, I was talking about the gem blocks. We could use those there, too.
Yeah, that's true. Yep, it took out all my torches.
Sorry.
That's okay.
You didn't do it on purpose, I swear. Do this ahead of time. Yeah, I guess you can stay there.
Monsters in the tunnel above me.
They're having a party.
Uh-huh.
It's the monster mash.
Oh, something I should do.
Wondering if I should line it.
That's our multi-twitch.
Can I put it away? No, that's right there. Oh, yes. That's a good point.
Yeah,
I don't see it in chat, so it hasn't done it recently.
I almost forgot about that.
I have to do that lowercase. There we go. So once we get all this stuff lined, my next planned project, unless somebody else has done it first, is to build the dungeon farm.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
So that's in place.
And I may need to go take a break real quick. What time is it? Yeah, hate to do it right now, but I'm gonna have to.
Okay.
I need to give Teddy more food.
Oh, yes. The cat will complain.
Uh-huh.
So glad that he's on the mend. I was worried about him there for a while.
I was too. Why is there a pressure plate there? Trap's already been removed.
I guess just never move the... I know I tend to take one piece of the trap, but not usually the dark part. I don't always take the pressure plate.
Oh, okay.
More often than not, I don't take the pressure plate. I just take the trap. To disable it.
Okay, I need to take a break real quick.
Alrighty.
I'll be back in just a couple of minutes. I will leave it on so they can hear your voice, but I'll be on my break screen. So I'll be back in a few minutes.
Alrighty then. Rupert was slain. Oh, right. Gotcha. That's not the guide, is it? I didn't think you were down there. oh, you moved him to the honey hut. Well, the next one should show up. No, he'll show up somewhere. Well, hopefully the next one can make it there. To the honey hut in safety. All right, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to make some gem blocks now, and I'll start putting the lights in as we go down. Now, I highly doubt that we have enough of any one particular gem. That would be nice, yes, to say the clothier always shows up here, or the guide should always go here, even if, you know, it's the nth iteration of said person. But alas, no. Alrighty, so what do we have? We have 137 topazes. 105 amethysts. Now the best light is the brightest light comes from diamonds. And we actually, no, that's Eternia crystals. 45 diamonds. That might be enough. Well, if nothing else, if we make them out of diamonds, do we need the diamonds for anything specific, Gore? Like any magic related thing that might need a diamond? No, not really. Okay. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take half the diamonds here, turn them into gem blocks, and we'll see how... I'll take 30. No, let's take 24. Okay, close enough. We'll turn that into gem spark blocks, and we'll see how far that gets us. I have a suspicion we might need more, so I might have to end up alternating them, like, say, diamonds and emeralds or something like that, or diamonds and amethyst. We'll see how it goes. Right. Okay, so gem spark blocks. Excuse me, Ryan. I need to know what I need to make gem spark blocks, because I don't make them that often. Glass. Lots and lots of glass. Okay, thank you. Need 20 glass per. Alrighty. Might have to go on a sand expedition if we don't have enough. We have 300 sand blocks. That's... Oh! I think you got enough sand. Okay, so we need 480 glass. How much is there any glass in here? There's 99 glass. Okay, we'll leave that there. Let's make 480 glass then. And glass. There we are. There we go. And our gem sparks. Oh, we get 20. Okay, that's more than I remembered. Okay, maybe we won't turn all these into gem spark. Let's make 200 gem spark blocks. And let's put the glass away. Let's put the sand away. That can go away, and that can go away. Did I have a box for these? I don't think so. And dirt. There we are. Okay, so let's see how far we get on 200. Maybe we can use diamonds all the way down. I do have to alternate them. Hello.
I'm almost back.
Okay. we do have to alternate them, I might intersperse rubies. I mean, it's the elevator after all, but let's try just the diamonds to start with.
Okay. And I keep tossing glow sticks.
On purpose? Or
because no, you're out? Because I keep trying to give the focus back to the game, and every time I do, by
it
clicking,
throws
it throws a glow stick.
Oh, well, that's very helpful, I guess. Okay, it's going to be dark at the top of the shaft here because I want it to... I'm not going to measure the lights out where they're going. I'm just going to do them by eyeball. And it helps if I can see the light radiations. Dang, I thought I took that away. Here. But I'll put on a shine potion so you can see. Chat, that is. I will be ending my afternoon stream in 15 minutes.
And I'll be ending at the same time.
Okay. But I will be back at 6 o'clock for the evening of Terraria. Close that. It's going to kind of mess me up there for as light goes, but... Oops.
Torches on both sides.
What's that?
Said it broke the torches on both sides. The water.
Yeah. Well, it spread out evenly if...
Well, I just remembered how we normally recess the torches into the wall or into the ceiling, so I'll go back and do that real quick.
Okay. Yeah, that's why I have my habit of putting them in a niche to try to stop that. Doesn't work so well on the water coming down. Unfortunately, you have to put it in, I think, 2 or 3 blocks to get it to not do it, which is too much of a pain. But for cross tunnels, I always stick them on the ceiling like 90% of the time. I do occasionally forget.
Corey, are you farming for something specific or are you just farming? A fake screen.
Yeah, we're going to get the lights from here, unfortunately, so maybe my plan to use the lights as a way to tell where things go is not going to work. Gory, I think Tex was asking if you are farming for anything specific or just farming for... something else, like money or something. You're just farming because you want to farm. Okay.
That's a legitimate reason.
Yep. Ah, using up the summoning items. Yep, might as well turn it into cash.
It's a good source of cash, too.
Yeah, and we're going to need a lot when we're trying to get good equipment. You know, get the best modifiers on things.
Mm-hmm.
That money goes fast.
I've got a question for you. Do you give your cats wet food?
I do. Their main source of food is the dry food, and once a day, now this is not including stuff, and she's an exception. The older cats become an exception, but the main horde get a can to share amongst the five of them, sorry, four of them, amongst the four of them once a day.
Oh.
So at 1 o'clock, and they know when 1 o'clock is coming, let me tell you. Because it's wet food is kind of like candy for cats if it's bad for their teeth.
Uh-huh.
So I don't use it as a main source of food. The exception is if they've lost most of their teeth, stuffing, they get a lot more wet food.
Oh, yeah. My cats, I've always given them wet food, and the dry food is a supplement.
Oh, okay, so their primary is wet.
Yeah.
Would you...
The thing I've been noticing about the wet food, though, is if you don't clean it up right away or clean their plates right away, it embeds on that plate and it's takes a lot of scrubbing to get it off.
Yeah, I usually soak them. Like, I just put them in the sink and soak them and come back, like, several hours later, and then they're really easy to clean.
So that's what was taking so long to feed Teddy.
Ah. Just scrubbing that.
Well, I clean his plate every time I give him food.
Ah. See, we have a stack of plates, or actually bowls. Like, Stuffin has a stack of 1-cup-sized glass bowls. And I just change it out for a new one. And then wash them periodically when I run out. The guys in the kitchen. Woohoo! Guess what I just got?
What?
Our cross beam or our cross path works as an excellent place to get a nymph. I just got a metal detector.
Nice.
She just showed up, but I didn't realize it was her. I was like, what keeps hitting me? And I was just killing it. Then I realized I just killed the nymph, and I got a metal detector.
Nice.
Woohoo!
Yeah, Fake Scream, I will in a little bit, but he's in the middle of eating right now.
Apparently I've killed four of them. Did I hear nymph hunting on this one?
Comes back and checks in with me, but he's mainly eating. And I do usually show him off on a regular basis on the stream.
Yes. I've seen Teddy Toes quite a few times.
Uh-huh.
I think I've shown Stuffin on stream once. She was in her basket, and I moved the webcam so it showed her, and she smelled it.
Yeah.
So everybody got a look at the cat nose, mostly. Alright, so I need some more. Let's see if we have any stone left. If not, then I'm going to have to go blow some crap up.
I've got 500 on me.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, and all I'm doing right now is redoing torches.
Okay. Yeah, we don't have anything to speak of for stone blocks.
And of course, now he's run off somewhere. Yeah, he's run off for now, Fake Scream. So it's gonna have to wait.
What, somebody wanted to see Teddy Toes?
Uh-huh. So he left as soon as he got what he wanted.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty, I'm heading towards you to rob you of some blocks.
Okay.
use crimtane ore for casing. is that a good idea? I don't know if your series are just trolling.
Let me place this one.
It doesn't spread crimson. Weird.
There you go.
Thank you.
Huh?
So, I'm just wondering if I could turn them into crimtane bars. Could I make crimtane blocks? Because if I could make crimtane metal blocks out of it... Well, I know I can place the ore directly, but it doesn't look as nice. I want it to look good. Because if you can make metal blocks out of it, Gore, if you could test the metal blocks to make sure they don't spread it either, then sure, if you got tons of it, then I'd be happy to use it.
And fake, his name is Teddy. It's short for teddy bear.
And he does look like a teddy bear.
He looked even more like a teddy bear when he was a kitten.
Oh, I can just imagine with that round head.
Uh-huh.
And he already has a round head, so even more so. Rounder than round.
So, torch placement is good.
Oh, let me just have a look. Yeah, that looks great. How far apart are you putting them, or are you just doing it by eye?
I'm kind of doing it by eye. I'm trying to move to a side and get them fairly evenly spaced.
Okay.
They may be a little bit too far apart, though.
Obsidian, actually, yeah. Obsidian would be good, too, now that we have a... Although, I'd need a lot of obsidian. But we do have a lot of lava in... Have you seen Gore's block farm above the building?
I did, maybe. Yeah.
Isn't that awesome?
Uh-huh.
So that's another option. So I think I'll finish up what I'm working on in the blocks that I have, but the main elevator shaft. Yeah, we could do that in obsidian. I think that would look nice.
You know, Fake, I do watch a movie every once in a while, but not very often. And I've seen the commercials for Ted 2, and it doesn't seem to be quite the type of humor I like.
Should be enough.
While I appreciate his humor, Seth Rogen isn't really one that I like very... Well, I can do him in small doses, but not large doses.
Do I have that on me? Yes, I do. And yeah, Nico, that's about it. She's like, what's this camera thing? At least she didn't lick the lens. She could have done that, but she didn't. Thankfully.
Loki was a licker. His way of letting people know that he liked them was by grooming them. So even complete strangers, if he liked a complete stranger, he would come up and start grooming your hand.
That's cool. I love when a cat does that. Don't ask me why, I just do. As long as they don't lick the same spot over and over and over and over and over, and you're like, ow, okay,
well, stop. Loki was such a strange cat to begin with. I would wake up at night and he would be grooming either the top of my head or my goatee.
Oh, jeez. It's funny.
Okay, I'll see you later, Fake Screen.
Val the cat does that to my husband. He has a goatee as well, so he will. He will groom it, and he's always like, "Okay, well, I need a bath now." Like, about to get all the cat spit off me. But he'll also wash the top of his head as well. Yeah. He'll basically lick any part he can get to.
And a dragoness raid. Welcome, everyone. Silver Dragon, Captain Camper, Evelyn, Sephiroth, Ishkaya, Panda, Kitsu, Ethan, Jax. Welcome, everyone.
So just a couple people.
Yeah, just a few. And let me put this back in chat. I'm currently streaming with Fowl's Noisy Toys.
Hello.
I think I spelled that right.
I think I hear Gory making me obsidian. Woo! All right. Let's get some light on this situation here.
And thank you for the hosts. Hey, Tossie.
We got a light there, but... I want to put them on alternate sides. So one right here.
And welcome everyone to the exciting world of torch placement.
And if for all alternative entertainment, you can watch me place gem spark blocks instead.
So we're both doing lighting.
You just made 460 obsidian. Nice, Gory. I have a feeling we're going to need a lot more. So I might be doing the exciting world of obsidian creation later. Once Gory gets bored.
Exactly, Kitsu. It's completely riveting. I used to have all the torches on the floor, but between me and Val, we kept breaking all of them. Yep.
Yeah.
With water.
Steve S. Guardian on Twitch, hello, and welcome to the stream. All right. See you in a bit. Actually, it's 4 o'clock, I just realized.
Yep.
So, that does mean that I will be... Oh, how much do I have left to do? Actually, yeah. I'm just going to finish lighting the part that I've done here. But I will be taking my afternoon break very shortly, and I will be back in 2 hours for 4 more hours of torch light placement fun. Actually... other things too, but we're preparing for hard mode, so there's going to be a lot of building and such.
Yeah, and that's what this is all about, is we're building the tunnel around our base to make sure that the Crimson and Hollow don't get to our base. So I'm checking lighting now. And running into mobs.
And Steve, thank you very much for the host. I appreciate that.
Yeah, guys, go show some love to Val as well.
Well, thank you. And I'll do the same, anybody that's watching me. even if you're on YouTube, if you ever watch on Twitch, please check out Texas Stream. His name is TEXCUBSF. So twitch.tv/TexCubSF.
Yep.
That doesn't look right. down lower.
And Demoness, did you do the rated for Dragoness?
I'm actually going to do it like that for the thing here. Looks nice. Boink. All right. Well, that'll do. For now.
Outrider.
All right, guys. I'm now heading off. I will be back, like I said, in 2 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And you guys, if I don't see you, you have a great evening. Otherwise, see you in 2 hours. Don't be late. And actually, Nico Nerva, do you stream on YouTube or Twitch? Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to call for a broadcaster salute in my chats. And if you're wondering what that is,
I'll do one at the same time.
Yeah, it was created. The idea concept was come up with by a fellow named Jax Mackey, who streams on Twitch. And that link actually will point you to an excerpt of when he came up with it. So go ahead and put 07 in chat if you are a streamer. And I encourage everybody that's watching to check whether or not you stream yourself. If you're somebody who is a viewer, check out these other streamers and give them a follow. And see if they've got content that you'd enjoy as well.
Yeah, and if y'all would do the same in my stream, go ahead and put 07 in as a broadcaster salute. I'd appreciate it.
Cool. All right, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in a couple hours.
Okay. Bye. Okay, guys, I am going to be ending for the next 2 hours. Since we've got so many people here, let's go raid someone. Let's see who's up and about. Just starting. Who do we have? I haven't raided Dr. Boo in a while. We've also got Sinful Deity. Or Sloth Monster. So who would you prefer? Dr. Boo, Sinful Deity, or Sloth Monster for a raid? And let me go ahead and get out of here. Well, I guess it's going to be Sloth. So there's the raid message. Let me get his link real quick. Maybe it'll help wake him up. There's his link. Wait for me to get over there to post the message. Y'all know the drill. You just did it. And I will see y'all over there. I will be streaming again in about 2.5 to 3 hours. I usually start a little bit later than Val does. But I'll try and get back a little bit earlier. So I'll see y'all over in Sloth Stream. Have fun.